It is finally here, and I welcome you all to our new house right here at Madhouse TV. And let me tell you something, if you only could have seen how and what went on in this place. 3 days ago, this place was empty. I can't even explain what has gone on in the last 12 days, what four people did. It's just incredible. I have a few people I want to thank, though, because without them, we couldn't have done this. And I also want to welcome you to Madhouse TV, the Maverick Soul Hour with Tommy Maher. And I have very special guests who you know we have tonight. We got some special people. This is going to be a great show. We're doing a special. It's going to be 90 minutes long tonight, not an hour. I welcome all of you to our new home. I mean, this place is incredible. I can't wait for you all to see it. It's just magnificent. I'm in love with it. I really am in love with it. But I do want to thank a couple people. First of all, I want to thank Tom, Tech Tommy. And by the way, while I'm thanking Tech Tommy, happy birthday, my brother. Happy birthday. And thank you so much for your help. Unbelievable. And I also have to send a very, very special thank you to my man, one of my guitar players, Joe Cortez, who came out of nowhere like he was sent from the heavens. And we did do a lot of praying. And I thank you again. I thank you for what you've let us create here, because it's actually a miracle, because we're the only ones. I mean, me and Vicky and Janine and Tom, we walked out of here. We were here all day Easter yesterday, and we just actually said somebody should be sitting outside patting us on the back as we walked out, because this place was a shell. I mean, it was just a shell, and we've come a long way, and you'll see. Hopefully, we'll be able to show you around a little bit. But Joe Cortez, I want to thank you, man, because without you, it wouldn't have happened. You are a very, 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 very good vibe, man, and I can never thank you enough, man. You made the whole day happen, else it wouldn't have happened. So, Joe, thank you. We got a lot more room now. We're going to be bringing in the big guns, which we have some big guns sitting on the couch over here, and you all know who that is, but we're going to wait. We're going to wait a little bit. And I hope that everyone had a great Easter and a great Passover. God bless you all. I hope whatever your thing is, I hope it was great. We were here working, but I hope everyone had a good time. We actually had a good time, too. I also want to, you know, let you guys know that as far as my Woodstock people, which you guys that know me, this rock here was under the stage in 1969. I was there, so I took it. I took a few rocks. They didn't have souvenirs or T-shirts, so I actually went under the stage and took some rocks. And Amber has one of my rocks, and she has it on her stage when she does her Joplin, which is incredible. And believe me, I told her when I gave it to her, it's going to bring you vibes that you can't believe. So I brought it in, and I said, we need the mojo in here. And it's all happened, and I really believe that the rock had something to do with it. And there's a few people that can back me up on that. And I also want to let you guys know, you know, the petitions to sign for Bethel, you know, for Yazgus Farm, you know, you can go through, Joanne Haig. They're due, April 9th. So if you did sign it, you know, you've seen it on Facebook. I had it on my Facebook, on my Woodstock Guru page. Just sign it. It's for us, you know, be able to go up on his own Roy Howard and Gerald Abrams' land and camp and have a little fun and some music and some peace and some love, and which God only knows this world needs so much more of, because it's a nightmare out there. And believe me, I've been to these, I've performed that at them. It's like leaving the real world and going into a fantasy world of all good people, you know. So sign that petition, and you know, all it's asking is just for them to allow people to sleep on their own land, you know, that's all. So if you do that, I also want to just let you guys know, you know, we have a reality. We have three things here. We have the television shows. We have many television shows, us included. We have 24-hour-a-day radio. We have actually Vicky and I are going to be doing a classic rock show. Probably, I think we're going to call it flavors of the day. You know, we're going to pick out some special bands and play that. And Tom and LJ have a, it's like, you know, the Insane Asylum show every morning at, what is it, 7:30? 8 o'clock, which I think is hilarious. I listen to it when I walk 5 miles every morning, and I listen to it, and I just, people think I'm nuts because I'm just laughing. So listen to that too. And you can actually get an app for your phone where you just hit the app and it goes right on your car radio. So it's pretty cool. And this is something I just want to say. I'm not trying to sell this because I think it's too cheap, actually. I would charge a lot more money. But we have a reality TV here also. And what I suggest to any band, you get your own TV channel for $4.99 a show. Now, so like, if you're going to a club and you're playing for 40 or 50 people, for a dollar a piece, you could perform to the world. So, you know, to me, it's a given. I mean, like, even big bands like these guys, I mean, everyone should do it. And not just bands. If you have talent, or you think, I know we have Frankie Prince is going to have a show, a comedy show. You know, kids, young teenagers, you guys get some shows together. It's so cheap. I mean, it's ridiculous. Me and Vicky argue it's way too cheap. So, huh?
Churches?
Anybody? Anything in the world that you might want to get out to the world? Hey, look what the Kardashians did, and they don't even have a talent. Sorry, but it's the truth. That's the way it is. Their talent is having no talent. So, have your own show, and you'll have your own channel 24 hours a day. And lastly, I have to thank my woman, Janine, because I could not ever have done any of this without her. There is absolutely no question about that. She is my heart, my soul, and I am only half of a person. So, and then lastly, before I lose it completely, I have to thank my partners, Vicky and Tom Mealy, for having the faith in me to be a part and giving me this wonderful opportunity to be a part of this business, which I feel is going to just explode. I honestly believe it's going to explode. Guys, I could never... Stop it, Mealy. I could never, ever thank you enough for having the faith that you have in me and allowing me... He's given me the bad sign, and it's not good. See, it's easy now. He's in an enclosed room watching me through a window, so it's pretty cool. So, guys, I love you guys. I love being with you. I think you're, like, my greatest friends right now, and I am looking so forward to this journey that we are going to take together. It's going to be absolutely, I believe, incredible. I just can't wait to get it going. And you guys out there, you know, you're really crazy if you don't become part of this. I mean, every band, I mean, even kids, it's a dollar a piece. And I'm not trying to sell it because, like I said, Vicky and I said, it should be $150. I mean, not $4.99. That's $4.99. So if you're in a band with five people, it's a dollar a piece. And you have your own TV station. So hook up with Madhouse Reality TV and do your thing. You know... You all know that I have my special guests here tonight, which, if you guys remember when, well, I know they remember because I met Amber. When I met Amber, we sat in a diner for 2.5 hours, I think, talking about, you know, and I said, if I ever get the show, you will be my first guest. And I promised her, and she was my first guest in the old studio. My first show was last June, and I told her, if when we get the new studio, you will be my first guest in this studio. And guess what? Again, my prayers have been answered. The Amber Ferrari Band is in the house right now, sitting right next to me. So what we're going to do, we're going to go to a little commercial break, and then we're going to come back. I'm going to introduce you to the band, and then we're going to actually show you Amber's CD release party at 89 North that we filmed, I don't know, what was that, 3 weeks ago?
March 9th.
And we also, I also want to thank while I'm standing here, the band, because, you know, we are such a, we feel like we're a part of them too, because we've been growing with them as they've grown, which we knew when I gave her the rock, I gave her a rock. I told her, watch the magnificent things that happen. So Amber Ferrari, Chris Ferrari, Eddie Yasnick, and Donna Schwartz. And I also want to say, Jim Carroll, where the hell are you? I mean, are you kidding me?
He's stuck.
When you see the interviews on this show, you're going to be embarrassed. And I also would love to thank Richie Cannata for being part of the show and being so gracious, and Bobby Rondinelli. I want to thank you guys for giving us your time with interviews and everything, and you were magnificent on stage. The band that opened for you guys was great with Bobby behind the drums. It was just an amazing night, which you're all going to get to see. You're going to get to see the interviews. You're going to get to see a little. We're not going to show you that much music because we want you to buy the album. So we're going to take a little break. We're going to come back. You're going to meet the band, and then we're going to take you to the rocket launching of the Amber Ferrari Band. So stick with us. Get yourself tight. We'll be right back with the Maverick Soul Hour. Hey, I'm Tom Mealy. I'm with Madhouse TV. This guy just walked up the steps. I don't know. What is the story with you?
I'm comedian Frank Prince.
Hey, what the hell do you want here?
I want my own reality TV show.
You think you're funny enough?
Hell yeah.
Well, how much money you got?
Short arms and deep pockets.
You think you can make it?
I'm the Myron J. Show.
You think?
I think.
All right.
I know.
We're going to give him a shot this spring here on Madhouse TV. Tune in and wait for
Frank Prince, the Myron J. Show.
There you go. We'll see you this spring. We got a ton of new shows coming up. My pal Frank Prince, great comedian. Wait to see him. Tune in to Madhouse TV this spring. Have a wonderful day.
You know you already want a Toyota, but when you want more from your Toyota store, you want Smithtown Toyota, where every Toyota comes with Smithtown Toyota's Toyota for Life program, giving you lifetime New York State inspections, lifetime 10% discounts on all parts and service, 2 years of complimentary oil changes, 2 years of scheduled maintenance, and more, all at no cost to you, plus low clear-out deals on every Toyota in stock. Get more from your Toyota store. Hurry to Smithtown Toyota.
Brooklyn's best locksmith and hardware.
We have three of the largest showrooms of safes on display and in stock. You can see and touch them in person instead of browsing a catalog. We carry gun and rifle safes, burglary safes, jewelry safes, fire rated from a half hour to 2 hours. Famous name brands.
We sell Gardall.
We sell AMSAC.
The new AMSAC touchscreen.
If you're ever in need of a safe, think Brooklyn's best locksmith and hardware. Right, Lockie?
That's right, Alan.
Shot. We are back in the new house, in the madhouse with the Maverick Soul. I am Tommy Maher, and I have special guests here tonight. But one is missing. Jim. Jim, what is it? Do we have them on camera? Yes, we do. Okay.
Hey.
I am honored to introduce you guys to the Amber Ferrari Band. It is such a privilege and honor to have these guys here. You will see that this rocket ship is about to take off. So right here, we have the lovely Mrs. Amber Ferrari, her husband Chris Ferrari, lead guitar, Eddie Yasnick, bass, and Donna Schwartz on the sax. And Jim Carroll is, he's not here. Again.
He's
Jim, what the hell is going on with you?
He's so disappointed, Tommy.
No, I know. I know, Jim. We love you. We know you're here in spirit. We feel your vibe. And I do know because I talked to you about it. I know you wanted to be here. He's teaching students, and God bless you for doing that, because never stop the music. Keep it going. They're taking it out of schools and everything. So it's guys like Jim Carroll that will keep it going. So, Jim, keep doing a good job that you're doing. God bless you, and we love you for it. But now we're going to get back to the live people that actually came here. So, Miss Amber, what do you think of the new house?
Congratulations, congratulations, congratulations. It is absolutely awesome. Wait until you guys see this place. It's off the hook. It's really, really fantastic. Wish you all the best. And I am so honored and thankful that once again I'm your first guest.
And now, you know, being that I got you here, you know, that stage over there, you know we're going to get you up on there.
I'm sorry, I'm not past that. I'm your first guest again.
Amber's first guest.
Oh, no. Darn it. I had to go put mascara on. You know, before I came, I did a thing on Facebook. Do I come wear makeup or no makeup? Everybody said no makeup. I put on mascara, and I'm crying.
It's like old hat already for us. We've been doing this so long. But I am so just thrilled that we got to take this journey to watch your journey.
And I'm so glad that you're taking it with me.
And you guys, I mean, we love you all. And Chris and Eddie and Donna, I mean, these guys are phenomenal, phenomenal musicians, which you will see. And they're more anxious because they haven't seen it. I only saw it once.
I know. I can't take it.
We're waiting for this. So what we're going
to
do is I think what we'll do, we're going to show you the CD release party at 89 North in Patchogue. Are we almost ready to roll that, guys in the house over there? All right, we're going to take you, and we're going to show you, and the band is going to see it for the first time, and I know a couple people here are going to see it.
I hope they said only good things.
Well, you guys said it.
I'm taking that. It's amazing. I'm kidding.
So what we're going to do is we're going to cut to the CD release party at 89 North, and then we're going to come back and we're going to critique it. We're going to listen to what they got to say about it, and we're going to talk about what's going to happen in the future with this band, which I already know what's going to happen. But you guys are going to know in a minute, too, after you see this. So we are going to sit back, get yourselves nice and comfortable, because this, I promise, you're going to enjoy. And musicians, I want you to listen to what is said, because what my dream of this of doing this show was I wanted to interview them before the show and after the show, because I wanted to feel what they were feeling. Because let's face it, we don't, you know, us non-mortals, whatever we want to call it, you know, that's every musician's dream, is to get to the point that they have already gotten to. And we were fortunate enough to be there to see the emotion, to feel the emotion. We were with them in the dressing room. We watched. We even interviewed Amber in the middle of her makeup, and she didn't even care, which I think is so cool that she's not a diva. She's like, I don't care. I'll go there now. I don't care. So hang tight. Get yourselves comfortable. This is about 36 minutes long. You're going to enjoy every minute. Listen to what they have to say, because this is a super band that's going to super places, I promise you. And you guys are all going to buy this CD. So we're going to roll this right now, and we're going to sit here and watch it ourselves. So I present you the Amber Ferrari Band and her new album, Electric Blue. We are here at 89 North in Patchogue, Long Island, for the big, the giant, the amazing CD release party of Amber Ferrari and her rocking band. And right now, I have, what happened to you? The only member of the band that didn't come on our show the other day. And this is Jim Carroll, and you are the drummer.
Yes.
So, Jim, my goal right now is to tell, I want you to tell me what you are feeling right now.
Well, I'm very excited. We worked very hard for this. We're ready, and I feel ready. I can't wait to get up there.
I would assume that the anticipation is like, you know, we're all living our dream through this, because we're going to get to see it happen, you know, because let's face it, you know, any musician, you want to get to this point where you're going to have a CD and a big release party and a big venue like this, and it's phenomenal. So we get to live, so that's why I want to know what you're feeling right in there.
And I know it's got to be good. And I've seen you guys many, many times, and you were an amazing drummer. I even said it the other night on the show. I think you're a fabulous drummer. I think you add a lot to this band. And what are you getting about the whole vibe of the whole thing so far with the sound check? Everything went all right?
Everything went perfect. Really? Couldn't be better. Yeah, everything.
That's amazing.
Going according to plan, which is
great. Well, that's rare, right? So... I want to thank you, and I'm sorry that we did miss you the other night on the show, because we're saving a seat and everything, but you never got there. But anyway, you will be on the other show when we run this show. You're going to come on with Amber and Chris, right? Well, listen, man, I wish you guys all the luck. Be blessed. Kick some ass out there tonight, and we're waiting to see it, man. We're very excited for you. God bless, and have a great show. All right? Cool. All right. Madhouse TV, the Maverick Soul Hour with Tommy Maher. I got my main man here, Chris, who's become quite a veteran of the Madhouse. And so, my man.
Thank you so much for coming down. Thank you for having me on your show.
Listen, that's silly. I really want to get the feel of, are you freaking?
Not freaking. I'm very excited. It's a thrill. I can't wait to get on stage and just to actually start to play this music for people. We've worked really hard on it. I'm very excited to actually get it out there. It's really some great tunes. I think people are going to really love it, and I'm really excited to be here tonight and to play it. So.
Well, I would hope. And the sound check went good. Everything
sound
went
check,
cool.
Yeah, the sound check went great. Sound is great. The stage is all set up, so I'm ready. I'm ready to go. I'm gonna get into my.
It's probably gonna take forever, right?
It's gonna be over in 5 minutes.
Well,
the first chord, and it's gonna be like, thank you, good man.
Well, like you're the you are the arranger of the band. You put all the music together. You're the workhorse. Is it a relief? I mean, is it still a stress, or I mean, are you feeling like, wow, we finally got here and got it over?
I'm glad. Yeah, we were waiting a long time for this for tonight, because it's going to start the road that we're going to be traveling on. So I'm just glad it's here. This is the beginning of the rest of the story. So I'm pretty excited to get going on.
Well, Chris, I'm a big believer, and I think it's going to be an incredible journey for you guys. I really, truly do. I think the journey is going to take these guys to places where us mortals only dream of going, So, tonight I'm going to get to live my dream through Chris, so, and Amber and the rest of the band. But, Chris, I just want to congratulate you, because I've seen the work and I've seen the band progress. From early on, I think it was the second show, and I've seen pretty much all of the shows, and I just want to say you've done an incredible job. You definitely did your job, I mean, people don't realize, because, I mean, Amber's beautiful, and Amber's a great singer and that, but, you got to go to the guy behind the scenes, too, and you did a magnificent job putting this thing together.
Well, thank you, but I do have to say that not only am I only lucky to be married to such a beautiful, wonderful person, but to play with the talent that she is, it's such a blessing that I, I can't really say. I don't have words.
And your bandmates too. I mean,
they're great. I mean, the whole band is just phenomenal. It's really such a gel. It's a family. It really is a family. Everybody really, it's really one
like
of those
we talked
things
about the other night on the show with the chemistry. I mean, you got a great, really great chemistry, and that's more important most times than the talent. It really is.
Yeah. I mean, everybody's talented, but it's just that gel and that chemistry really is.
Take it from me. I mean, there's usually an apple in every crate that's getting a little rotten, but that's what I mean. That's why I think you guys are really, really blessed to have such a great chemistry, and it's rare nowadays, and they're all good people too. And I'll tell you, I couldn't be happier for you guys. I'm glad that we're getting to take the journey along with you, and I thank you for letting us come here tonight. Don't you thank us? We thank you.
On many a shows.
Oh, well, we'll travel around. You get that Learjet going, we'll be with you. But all the best of luck, and I truly mean that as a brother and a friend.
On your partnership.
Oh, thank you. And we're going to have you in the studio live, in the new studio with the big stage, the real deals. So this is my man. I tell you, I love this guy. And I can't wait to see where this journey takes them. I really can't. So, Chris, you're my man. and go out there and kick some serious ass tonight, man, and have fun. Have fun. All right? Chris Ferrari. Look who I have on the Maverick Soul Hour right now. My man, and I know you're the Maverick of the band. I know that.
I know that.
You know that for sure?
This is my man, Eddie Yasnek, and he is the bass player for the Amber Ferrari Band. Now, Eddie was on the show the other night. We were chatting, and we were talking about excitement and where you were that night, which was Monday night, right? Where are you at now?
I want to play.
I know you
I want to play.
Where's your head at?
I am excited. I want to get on stage and start making some noise and play. In that zone right now, it's just to get up there and start.
Well, as a fellow musician, it's probably all of our goals is to get to where you're at now. And that's getting a CD out there publicly and where, you know, people can buy it. And this is a real deal. I mean, this is a big club, a big venue. And, you know, I want to hear what's I mean, oh, is boy. It hot? Are you nervous?
No, I'm not nervous. I'm psyched.
I know you
I'm
are.
Not nervous.
That's why you're a Maverick.
Yeah, I want to, you know, just get up there and start that first song and, you know, play that role, do what I do, you know. I like feeling the bass, I like hearing the band. I mean, it's an awesome band. These people are great people, and it's cool.
How's your wife holding up?
She's great. she's enjoying the ride.
Well, like I was saying with Chris, I mean, I know all you guys. I've followed the band, you know, from get-go. The chemistry is so good, and the friendship seemed to be real. It's not, you know, like, you know. Let me just get along with this guy.
No, Chris and I are really, really tight, and Jim and Donna. I mean, we're all great. Amber and I get along great. I mean, we text her in the day, we laugh, and it's just a good group of people.
Isn't that how it should be?
That's the way it should be.
You know, and how many bands? Nonsense. How many bands have you been in? That just
a
like
a lot of bands and a lot
stress
of
city, right?
And yeah. Egos and yeah. Drama and it's too much. And this band is just everybody's on the same page.
Yeah. And you got a goal, and you're actually getting here now, and here's the end of the rainbow.
This band just works. It just gels. I mean, when they come down, like Chris will come down with a riff, and Amber will come down with some, you know, lyrics, and we just get together, and we just knock it right out.
Yeah.
It's just, we're so on the same page.
Well, that's
everything just kind of rolls. Yeah, it's awesome.
And it's everybody being in the same mindset, too, musically.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, you just can't do that if you're not in the same head musically.
Yeah.
And you see that on stage with you guys. You
yeah.
know, you can see it. No one's like, where am I going here? Or, you know.
Oh, no.
You're tight.
Yeah.
And it's right. And
it's going to be out of sight.
It is.
It's definitely going to be a great. I can feel it. The place is going to be jamming. You got a great band opening for you. And I think you're going to knock the hell out of it tonight. I really, truly do. And I'm really excited for you guys. You believe that? No, I really, truly am. I wish you guys all the luck and will, and you know that.
Glad to hear, man.
And you got to come back, and you're gonna play live in a new studio, right?
Yes.
Without a doubt, right?
Oh yes.
Well, I'm telling you, my man, I want to see you leave it on the floor out there tonight. All right?
You're gonna be right out there, right?
I'm gonna be right there, cheering you on.
We're gonna go, right?
Are we doing hands up?
Hands up.
Hands up.
Hands up.
All right, man.
Okay.
Thanks, man.
Thank
Be
you,
good and kick some ass and have some fun.
I will.
Have fun.
Thanks.
That's the main thing. My man, right there. Now, my favorite Maverick soul is sitting here right now. Miss Donna Schwartz, sax. And let me tell you something, guys. This girl can play. I've seen her many, many, many times. I think you are such a big asset to this band. And I think that, you know, you can see the friendships that you have, you know, with Amber, and I mean, and you can, and when you see stuff like that on stage, it makes a big difference. I mean,
do you agree?
Oh, absolutely. Actually, Amber and I have long known each other for a long time. We did a big gig at the Westbury Music Fair. I forget what it's called now. I think it's New York City Bank or something like that.
Yeah, it's Westbury Music Fair.
I know, it changes names. We did a gig years ago. She did a deadpan Tina Turner impersonation, and I actually did a Yakety Sax solo. It was a big gig for us, and I've known her ever since then. We played a couple of gigs since that point, but no, this has been great. Like the other guys were saying, this is a family. You know, we get along like a family. We tease each other, you know, we have a great time, and we just really gel.
And that's what makes it good, because, you know, I'm sure you've been in a lot of bands. There's always something going down, you know, bad, and to have that chemistry, and, you know, I mean, I think that's why you guys are where you are.
Absolutely.
You know, I mean, you're not here because you know, are fighting and hitting people with guitars and stuff, you know.
You know, we're all in it for the same goal. We're taking this seriously. We believe in this music, and we think that Amber's got a phenomenal voice, and we all compliment her really well, and we work great as a unit. So I think it's just a great mix of people.
I do, too. I think that's the key. I actually do. And you got great songwriters. You got great people working with you. You got great musicians. I mean, it's hard to go wrong. I mean, you're not here for no reason. You're here for a reason. You were meant to be here.
Absolutely. You know, it's funny because a couple of years ago, my other band had disbanded. And I was looking to get into another band, and I thought of Amber, and I emailed her. And then a couple months later, she gave me a call and said, hey, you know, we're going to start something up. And we were having ESP. It was great. We were on the same wavelength.
Well, there you go. The vibe is there. So that was it was meant to be. You were meant to be here. So, I mean, I really, really, really can't wait to hear you guys play. How are you feeling now?
I just, like the guys were saying, I just want to be on the stage. I'm like, the hardest part is waiting. Yeah. I just want to play.
Pounding? Are you nervous?
No, I'm not pounding. I am a little nervous, but it's good because you want to be a little nervous. You want to have that nervous energy to propel you forward. If I wasn't nervous, I'd be nervous.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I have some nervousness in me.
Dying.
But
I'd be dying. But
no, but you know what? It's because we gel so great together. You're going to love not only the songs that you're going to hear from the CD, the new stuff we came up with. It's phenomenal. You're going to love it.
I can't wait, girl. You know that. You know I can't wait to hear that because I love these guys, and I'll tell you something. You've always been a very favorite of mine, and I love the way you are on stage. You interact well, and I like when you step out with your solos. I mean, you know, I think it's just the chemistry just blows me away, and I could not be happier for you guys. It's like watching, you know, a flower grow, you know what I mean? And here it is. Here we are. And then I guess you can't wait for this other band to get rolling so you get up there, right?
Absolutely.
So, well, Donna, I wish you all the luck. You deserve all the luck in the world. I know that you guys are going to be fine. You're going to take a journey that's going to take you to places you probably never dreamt of going. And I really believe that. And you're a major part of that. And I wish you all the luck in the world. And I really, really, really wish you and bless you and want you to have a lot of fun tonight.
No, thank you. And thank you for all your support, supporting us, all the interviews, and just being here and taping this. And I got to tell you, personally, it's great for me. I have a lot of friends across the country who obviously can't be here tonight, right. So they're really looking forward to that live web stream tonight.
Well,
they're not going to see the live web stream tonight. I don't know when exactly it's going to happen, but they're going to see everything. We got to edit it. But, We're gonna show everything. We're gonna have you back in because I wanted your feelings before, and I want to feel your feelings afterwards. I want to feel when you guys come off stage what you're feeling, what you know, the rush and the whole thing, and it's all gonna be cool. I just really want you to have a good time, and this is the moment you've been waiting for. This is what every musician has dreamt of, you know, and it's actually happening for you. So.
That's
I mean,
true. Yeah.
You know, this is the deal, man. I mean, like, I'm living through you guys tonight, you know, because, you know, we almost get there, but, you know,
this is the real deal.
You're here.
Yeah.
It's here. And we're in the ship with you. So skyrocket to the moon. Have a blast. Have fun and leave it all on the stage. That's all I got to say. And thanks so much for stopping by.
Thank you.
And you're going to play live in the studio, right?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
All right. Donna Schwartz. Thank you, Donna. Now who look. Look who we have here now. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce my Maverick girl right here, Miss Amber Ferrari. Amber, it's happening. It's happening. It's here.
Yeah, it's here. I can't believe it.
What are you feeling?
Right now, I am excited, a little nervous. I'm trying not to cry, and putting my face together.
Yeah, we got her. Let me just tell you, we got her in the middle of makeup, and you know, but she's cool. She's not like that. She's no diva, you know. She don't care. Well, like I was telling the rest of you guys, I mean, what excites me about this band, and you know that I've seen you from the get, and. Is the chemistry. I mean, obviously the songwriting between you and Chris is phenomenal. So that's a given. I'm going to give you that. But it's the building of the ship. you know, that where I think really is where the professionalism comes in. I think you, I don't know, I'm sure you handpicked each person. Wherever, in whatever way it happened, it was meant to happen. Like, I mean, I know they were talking about how Eddie got involved. And I mean, I'm not even going to get into it, but it was like, you know, it was a freak thing, right?
We're all like a family, and I'm sure everyone has said that. We get along great, and they know that I won't deal with any nonsense. I'm sorry, but
hey, you know, somebody's got to be at the wheel.
And it's very hard, as you know sometimes.
Oh, let me tell you. Let me tell you.
You know, good friends. Right. You become close friends.
You take a lot home with you.
And you become a family, but it's also a business, so it makes it difficult. But everyone respects everyone. Everyone's phenomenal. I have a great band behind me. Yeah, I can go up there and do my thing, but if I have someone playing like garbage behind me, it's not going to work. Right. And everyone is a phenomenal musician. I love them with all my heart. And they know when I'm like hairy and I put my foot down, like, yeah, okay, okay, okay. But they're, like, I'm just very blessed to have the team that I have behind me playing. And they know my every move, you know.
Well, and they're very blessed to have you. And Chris and everybody. I mean, it's a blessing that you're all in the same place. That you were, it was meant to be.
This is what,
at this time, you were all meant to be right here. And I really believe in that. And there's a reason you're here, and it's because you were on a mission. It's like building a business, you know?
It is.
And you're the president of the business.
I have to say, I had put my started putting the band back together June, July of 2011. And the past year and a half has been absolutely amazing because of people like you who met me and have the outlet to tell people about me and to support me. See, now I'm just my makeup. Thank God it's all waterproof, but I don't know how much it's gonna.
We're not gonna let it do that.
And all of my friends, and I like to call my fans my friends because fans just feels uncomfortable what I say because I want people to know I'm talking about them. I'm afraid if I say to my friends that, well, what about me? So I always say friends / fans.
I agree. I hate that word.
Following me along the way, coming to every show, telling their friends about me, spreading the word. Without all of them, they're all gonna be here tonight. I wouldn't be where I am, or my band wouldn't be where we are now. And thank you with all of my heart, Tom.
Well, and also too, you know, like we, you know, I have a few different Facebook pages and that. So I have all my crews, you know, sitting and waiting. The Ya-Ya's, the Woodstock Guru, the Ya-Ya's. Well, some of them might be here tonight.
Oh,
there's going to be some.
So I can make a shout out to the Ya-Ya girls.
But nerves. Or just ready to roll?
No, not really. Nerves, not yet. Right now, I'm just ready to roll, and I'm very, very excited. I will, however, feel nerves the first word out of my mouth, you know, the first note. After the first few lines,
you're rough and running.
I'm in my own world. I feel the music, and literally, I don't know what I do on stage. I don't know what I look like. I do not know what I'm saying. It's off the cuff and from the heart.
That is what I love about you. You don't even care.
No, I don't.
You don't care. You only care about delivering.
We're going to have to get this video clipped for your show. There's a part we were watching me when I was doing Janice. Me and my friends Marie and Carol, who will be here tonight, they always video every show. God bless them. They're everything. And I love them to death. They're like my sisters. There's a little part of the clip during when I'm singing Peace of My Heart where I literally, on beat, punch myself in the head. No, and I'm not talking hit. I take my fist and I punch myself in the head. It's hysterical. I really should send it to America's Funniest Video.
Maybe I should do that.
Does that work to get you here?
Or, you know.
I don't know. I didn't even think, why did you do that? Why did I do what? They go, you're punching yourself in the head. I'm like, no, I'm not. I punch myself in my head. So we'll see what happens tonight.
Don't bring any bats out there with you. But I want to just say it's been such an honor and privilege to watch you guys grow because you've come even a long way, even since a year ago.
A long way. Yes, absolutely.
I mean, and it's just gotten better and better and better and better. And I think you're going to blow people away. I don't think. I know you're going to blow people away tonight. And I through this show, hopefully, I mean, like we're in 74 countries. You know, there might be 500 people downstairs, but you know what? We're gonna open you up to 100,000 people around the world. And we want them to see you because, you know, there's only 500 going to see you tonight, and there should be more. And
well, the place can only hold 500.
No, well, I know. And it's sold out, by the way.
The 500 people who have been here from the beginning, and they're taking the journey with us. And those are the people that, when I play my dream location, Madison Square Garden, they will all be there, and they'll be reserved front seats just for them, just to say thank you. Absolutely.
Well, that's cool. And I believe you, too. I know you're not a diva. But I got to say, it's I'm so excited for you. I really am. And it's going to be, I think you're just going to blow people away tonight. And you're going to, and I really believe that, like, you know, I mean, I know there's a couple of shows tonight in magazines and whatnot. The world needs to know about you guys. And we're going to do our part to do that. And, you know, whether we run the show a few times or whatever we're going to do. And then you're going to come in the studio and
absolutely
play live.
Absolutely.
And, you know.
And you're going to have to sing with me on your show.
I know.
Yes, yes.
I know.
Maverick sing live with us. Yeah. And he will be our next big Janis Joplin.
Well,
show.
If I'm still alive, we'll be all right. But anyway, she's going to make me.
Yeah,
I know.
Sorry.
But I just want to just tell you how proud and honored that we are and for allowing Madhouse to come up.
Thank you so much for wanting to be here.
Well, we're dying to be here. But, you know how much we love you. I just know that you're gonna kill, and I know you're gonna leave it all on that stage tonight. I know it. But the main thing, we want you to have some fun. All right.
Donna, talk to us, Donna.
It was great. A lot of support.
Tell her how you felt while you were up there on that stage, looking out at that crowd.
It was electric. I mean,
seeing Tommy's face.
It was so nasty.
No, it was phenomenal. It was great. A lot of support from everybody. Everybody, you know, loved the band, loved Amber. Amber put on a phenomenal show. So, it's good stuff. Definitely good stuff.
Poor girl,
until
she gets off the stage, she's like...
Well, this is what we wanted, right? You said that. We want to get the air.
We're limping off now.
Drained.
Oh, my God. All right, Tommy.
Hit me with it. Hit me with your best shot.
Hit me.
So how'd it feel?
Good. I took my hat off and my sunglasses, but it was cool.
How was the playing with your son?
That was awesome. And tomorrow I'll probably catch him in a day or two. I realized it was so funny because then he got into it and he was just rocking with Amber. I'm like, look at him go. This is awesome.
You're going to have that memory for the rest of your life.
That was awesome.
Should we pan over there? And...
Look at these two.
See what music can do for you?
There she is.
It was awesome. The response was just great.
You looked like you had fun.
I had a lot of fun. I can see it. I love it every second. It was a lot of fun. Without a doubt. I could see it in your face. Everybody, but the whole band was, I mean, the sound was great. Everything was great.
I love the response. Yeah. The new songs. You know, some of us heard these songs before. And the response at these songs ended was phenomenal. That made it all worthwhile.
You did a good job.
Yeah.
I tell you, man, it was great being here watching. It was phenomenal. It really, really, truly was. And we're going to get to see you in the studio tonight. And they'll be back while we run the show.
It's the whole band.
Oh, I think we're bringing everybody. We're bringing everybody. It's a madhouse.
And there you have it. And there
Michelangelo.
It
All right, here we are. Now, here's the man that kept down the beat all night long. How did it feel?
Felt good. A little tired now, but great.
But a good tired.
Oh, man. Absolutely. Absolutely.
It was a great show, and I'm telling you, man, you sounded unbelievably good. They had you, the mix was great. The sound was, everything was perfect. It was really, really perfect. And you held it down really, really, really
Thank
well.
Thank you.
And you got a good bass player, too.
Oh, right yeah.
There. So you got a good little
He's my buddy. Going. Oh, yeah. Oh, he's my partner, crying.
Yeah. Well, I want to congratulate you guys. You did a phenomenal job tonight.
Thank you.
I think you blew the people away. I really do. So God bless and thanks. Like and we'll see you at the studio, right? You're going to make it this time.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm going to make sure none of my students keep me from going.
Well, that's important, too, but we'll get you. We want to get you down there. Here we are here in the madhouse, right here at 89 North. The show is over, and they're coming in one by one. Bring the both of them over here. Bring these two pretty ladies over here. Come on over here. I want to hear what did you guys think of the show?
What? It was awesome. I have to tell you, all the original music, I thoroughly enjoyed. Each song got better and better as the night went along, I think.
Absolutely. It's fabulous. Really,
Amber really
great.
Knocked it out. The band was phenomenal.
Yeah, and
Richie
Tom's
Cannata
boots,
put the extra special touch on it. Everything was great.
She did rock it out, man. What'd you think, Michelangelo? Some good stuff, huh?
And the costumes were gorgeous.
And the outfits were really sharp, too. She looked good. She looked good.
Yeah.
This is Mr. Michelangelo over here. So, there you have it.
Well, here you have it from me right now, and I really thought that this was a completely, well... In her words, awesome, but that word is just so terribly overused so much. So I'm just going to say, totally awesome. No, it was really good. This woman has so much energy on the stage. She has so much energy with that voice. She's incredible. This Amber Ferrari should be seen by the world.
All right, we have Chris. And Chris, you had the opportunity to open the night up.
Yep.
What was the feeling?
Like nothing else.
Well, did you ever play in front of that many people before?
I played in front of that many people playing drums but not guitar.
I was there, I saw that.
Yeah.
That was cool.
Yeah, I wasn't used to it doing the guitar, but it was different and I liked it.
Well, how was it
playing with your dad?
It was good because me and my dad really never played together.
But what a memory for the rest of your life, right?
Yeah.
And that's cool. That's good stuff. Really Look at was. Mom over there smiling. Come here, Mom. Come over in here. Get in here. Now, what did you think of your baby son?
I love my baby son. My baby son is.
He did
I'm
great,
so
right?
proud of him. Yes. He
was
did
a great.
Great.
Show.
He did awesome.
And Dad was unbelievable tonight. I listened to bass players very carefully. He was tight tonight. Let me tell you something. He had a great sound tonight. Really.
Yes, he did. Yeah. He sure did. So. But I'm always proud of my boy. He's a talented
and
kid. My
and
husband's
your husband.
Talented. Yes, and I'm just here, being proud of both of them.
Well, that's a cool thing. So.
Thank you.
Thank you. And thanks. Man, all the best to you. And we're gonna see you. We're gonna see you on the show very shortly. One of these days. You got to get some band together now.
Okay.
But if you want to come on, we'll get you on too. Okay.
Thank
all right.
You.
All right. We're live right after the show, Madhouse TV, the Maverick Soul Hour. And guess who I'm standing here with? Mr. Richie Cannata from the Billy Joel Band from the get-go, right?
That's right.
So how was it tonight?
It was awesome. Amber is just a ball of fire. She's amazing.
I think she's like that. I know she's like that all the time. That's a scary part.
She was amazing. I just love her energy. I love her music. I love what she represents. And it's all about the music for me, and that's what she does.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's great.
And we are extending an offer to you anytime you want to come on the show.
And I'll take you up on it.
All right, cool.
I'd love to do
you
that.
You can even bring your jam, you know, whoever you want.
Bring the jam band or do maybe a duo, do something. Sure,
yeah,
it'll be fun.
Whatever you want to do.
Let's
whatever
set it up.
Do. Oh, we'll do it, definitely. I can't thank you enough. And
thank
you guys, you sounded awesome tonight.
Thank you.
And you worked it really good with her together.
Good.
Both of you are great.
You are watching Madhouse TV.
And that's Richie Cannata from the Billy Joel Band. Thanks, Richie, so much, man. It was a pleasure.
Okay.
All right, thanks. All right, we're going. Can we get you? Here she is, ladies and gentlemen. Miss Amber Ferrari, how was it?
It was amazing. I had so much fun.
You
and to have
like
the crowd singing along was awesome.
Everything
Thank
worked
you
perfectly.
Thank you so much for coming.
And I'll tell you, we just interviewed your whole band.
Oh!
And they are all juiced up and, I mean, revved up. Even Richie was,
awesome.
It was great.
I'm so glad. Thank
it
you so much.
It was so good. The sound was so beyond good.
Thank you.
And your energy, that's the word of the night.
Thank you.
Energy this woman has. And we here at Madhouse, we wish you every bit of luck that you so much deserve.
You've been
a treasure to us and a treasure to Long Island, and we are behind you 1,000%. And God Almighty, that was a show beyond shows.
Thank you
and
so
your
much.
Outfits were killer. So,
thank you so much.
We had the killer on the Madhouse, the Maverick
thank
Soul,
you
Tommy
thank
Maher,
you.
Miss
you,
Amber,
I love you. Thank
we
you
love
so
you,
much.
And you were.
Thank you, everyone.
What a show,
thank
I'm
you.
Telling you. And I must say, everybody out there from Madhouse TV, buy this album. You're a fool if you don't. You're a fool.
Thank you so much,
we
Tom.
Love
you.
Old Spice Body Spray will make you feel so powerful to blow your mind right in front of your face.
Goodbye.
Oh, no!
Automatic freshness, softness, and static control has never been easier with the Bounce Dryer Bar. I just stick it to the inside of my dryer, and I never have to remember.
Oh, Old Spice Body Spray makes you smell like power! It's so powerful, it sells itself in other people's commercials! You smell like outdoor freshness.
You smell like power?
Yeah, I do! Power!
Try this route.
Hey, I'm Tom Mealy. I'm with Madhouse TV. This guy just walked up the steps. I don't know. What is the story with you?
I'm comedian Frank Prince.
Hey, what the hell do you want here?
I want my own reality TV show.
You think you're funny enough?
Hell yeah.
Well, how much money you got?
Short arms and deep pockets.
You think you can make it?
I'm the Myron J. Show.
You think?
I think.
All right.
I know.
We're going to give him a shot this spring here on Madhouse TV. Tune in and wait for
Frank Prince, The Myron J. Show.
There you go. We'll see you this spring. We got a ton of new shows coming up. My pal Frank Prince, great comedian. Wait to see him. Tune in to Madhouse TV this spring. Have a wonderful day.
Ray, I don't know. Are you sure clicking this thing will get us online?
Well, try dragging it.
Faster.
You're just a mouse click away from a better way to rent movies. Blockbuster Total Access. Movies through the mail plus movies through the store. One low price.
Here's the problem. We forgot to plug it in.
Oh, don't even think about it.
Get a free trial at your Blockbuster store or Blockbuster.com.
This is Beth.
Hi.
Oh, congratulations. When are you due?
I'm not pregnant.
Oh, look at that. Excuse me.
You're totally thin.
You look very sexy.
For life's bleachable moments, all it takes is 3/4 cup.
One resident describes her horrifying experience when she first realized the complex was on fire.
I got bronchitis. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time for that.
Well, I woke up to go give me a cold pop. Then I thought somebody was barbecuing. I said, oh Lord Jesus, it's a fire. Then I ran out, I didn't grab no shoes or nothing, Jesus. I'm running for my life.
Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time for that.
I said, oh Lord Jesus, it's a fire. I said, oh Lord Jesus, it's a fire. I said, oh Lord Jesus, it's a fire.
Was that phenomenal? We were all crying. Everybody in the place. Well, not everybody, but me and Amber were crying. I do believe Chris had a tear in his eye, and I even think Eddie had a tear in his eye. Donna, I couldn't really see, but that was great. I mean, what do you think about that? Her coming down the stairs and living her dream. I mean, it was a moment when she makes that right turn, and that guitar kicked in. I mean, man, that was the emotional part because. That was her life's dream right there, that moment. You guys got to see it. You got to capture that moment. And that was pretty goddamn cool, I got to say. Oh, sorry, bud. I'm kind of like a little lost for words because, I mean, we all sat here and watched that. And most of us, they never saw it at all. I saw it once quickly. I know Janine didn't see it. I don't know if Vicky saw it. Did you see it? She didn't see it either. So we all got to see it really for the first time, and I think it was great. We would have loved to throw in you some more music in there of the show, but the reason we didn't is because now we want you to go buy the album. And Amber, how can they buy this album? Because I know there's a lot of people drooling to buy it right now.
There's a few ways. You can go online to my website, amberferrari.com, and it's on the home page. It clicks right to the link to purchase the hard copy of the CD. Or if you happen to live in Suffolk County, Long Island. You can go visit one of my sponsors of this year, Family Melody Music Center in Patchogue, has the CD on hand. Or you can purchase it online and download the songs from, you know, iTunes, Amazon.com, Napster.
All right, well, as you know, we're in 74 countries right now. So I have a lot of friends in Germany and England that are very big fans of yours now through this whole thing. And so they want to know. So Amazon,
you can get the hard copy on Amazon as well if you want to get the actual with the artwork that Rich Balta. I love you, Rich Balta. Hooked up the artwork too. For that CD. Yes.
I invited him to come down tonight.
He couldn't come because...
Okay. Well, Rich, we know you're here in spirit.
Well, yes. And I left the DVD home.
I know.
I know. Sorry. But next time we come back...
Oh,
we
definitely.
Can show that.
Well, you got to come back and play live. Yeah,
absolutely. And but everyone who's out of state they've been actually sending me messages. You can get it online. Go to my website, amberferrari.com. On the homepage, there's a link that takes you right to it to purchase the hard copy. Or like I said, iTunes, Amazon.com, Napster.
Well, I know that I personally get a lot of messages from people from France, from people from Germany, Sweden, Norway, you know, they're all juiced up in what they want to know. So you guys around the world, you know, now that Amber is out there in the world, not just in Long Island, it's out there, and she's going to, the whole band is going to take a ride right to the rocket ship, right to the stars, and that's how you got to get the album. I'm telling you, I have it. We had it all cranking in here before they even got here. And, you know, it's just an incredible album and incredible people. And it's a joy to have them here. It's a joy to watch them launch their journey. And
very exciting.
I want to hear a little input from, let's start with Miss Donna Schwartz over there. What did you think, Donna?
You know, watching that, it put me back in the moment, and I felt like I want to play again. You know, I want to jump on the stage right now.
All right, well, we got one.
Oh, great. Here we go. Let me get my horn. No, it was really great filming. It was just such a phenomenal night. It really was.
It was.
And I'm glad that, you know, a whole bunch of viewers are now seeing, you know, what happened that night, and I'm just
and
really...
I know that you have a lot of friends throughout the country that
yeah.
have been waiting. So I hope that we hear from you and tell us what you think, you know, but because Donna has quite a following throughout the country, so.
Yeah, no, they're really excited. You know, they were telling me they were looking forward to this moment to watch the show right now, and, you know, they were very eager to see the 89 North show, so really happy that you were able to be there. We really appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Oh, it was our pleasure. Mr. Edward.
I thought it was great. I liked the... You know, the interviews, everybody was raw. It was real raw emotion. That was what you got.
That's what
raw
I was.
And after.
That's what I wanted.
You know, you heard the things that were being said in before and after. And then you got that little family gathering at the end of that.
Well, I think, you know, that's something you're going to, you know, you're going to treasure that so much down the road.
Yeah.
That is something that you're going to play your grandkids. Really. Well, trust me.
Yeah,
I mean, I have six grandsons. And I showed them pictures of, like, when I played in Little League and stuff.
Yeah.
And they get all excited. So. And I mean, what a pleasure to have your son on the stage.
It was just the first time I saw it, so to see him on stage with you, it was funny. I went off to the side, and there he is, you know. It was you and, you know, the three of you guys were in there, but he was rocking away. Anyway, I got a kick out of it. I thought it was great.
Well,
I thought everything was cool. Coming down the stairs, I liked the interviews before. I liked when she came down the stairs, and then, because I had said to Chris, we were on stage already. She had turned and came up the stage, right. And it was just, I felt the moment again, like Donna said, you definitely went back, well, we were there, so,
right.
You know, I felt that again, yeah. And now I want to go do it again, let's go back and do it again.
You're doing it a lot, I'm sure of that.
And I thought that was cool, it was great, it was just awesome, and I used the word awesome.
And I'm glad, I am very glad for you and your wife, you know, you got to give this guy some more props too, you know, but, you know. He's an awesome bass player. But we did invite her down. She's working, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so we know you're also here in spirit, and your son.
Yes,
we're going to get you in here, too. We're going to get you on that stage because this kid can play, too. So, Mr. Chris Ferrari, let's hear what you got to say.
It was nice, actually, to see it from a different perspective because during the night, you're so engrossed in what's going on that everything's kind of like a blur. So it was nice to be able to see a little bit of it from a different perspective.
And actually see your own emotion.
Yes.
You know, because your mind is... But
it was nice to be able to hear what the other bandmates had to say, too, because weren't able to really hear the interview right. So much. So it was nice to hear everybody's perspective and their comments.
And the good thing about that was they all had that family. I think every single person talked about family.
It seemed to be the theme.
Well, let me tell you, it's better than throwing chairs at each other like I know a lot of other people
feud.
I know. But did you watch that Eagles thing?
Yes.
It could be like that, you know.
Let's hope not.
But that's the great part, that you all are a family, and you know you're all. It's like getting in a van and going to Disney World together. You know, you know, it's a happy thing, and it's a happy ride. You know,
we'll have the bus.
Now they're gonna get a fist fight over there. But,
yeah. I'll win that easily.
What are you calling your bookmaker in there or what? I enjoyed that too, and that's how, you know, I think I did call you and ask you if it was okay, because that was
the
vision that I seen, because as a musician, I personally wanted to have the emotion before, during, and after of the show, and I think we captured it pretty good.
Absolutely.
I mean, watching you guys come in, you know, it was such a difference when you were, you know, at the beginning interview, and then coming in afterwards. It was like it reminded me actually of that the movie Song Remains the Same, when you see Zeppelin end the concert and then they're leaving and they're getting in the limos and stuff, and they're like, you know, it was like
you had the sigh, you're like,
yeah.
You had your electric blue towel.
Oh wait, me and Jimmy Page in the same sentence? Oh wait a second.
Hey.
That's it.
Jimmy, are you watching? This is, they can, good openers here for you when you guys get back together.
2014.
Please. But so, Amber.
Yes.
Tell me what you were thinking. And don't you cry.
I don't think I can anymore because you let me, I let out a big one before.
Yeah, she had.
It was very nice to hear what bandmates had to say. She said I was too busy doing my makeup and everything. So that was very awesome to hear, touching. Because I'm not going to look at them because I'll cry, but I love them all very dearly. And Jim Carroll, AK, we call him Buddy Blinker. That's his nickname. We love you and miss you and wish you were here. But the part that got me was the stairs. Yeah. Because...
We got to give Tom credit for that.
Tom, that was awesome. It came out awesome for many reasons. Just all the hard work going up to that night. All the love and support from all of you who are watching tonight, all of your fans that have become my fans, thank you so much. Friends, like I said, I like to say friends. Yeah. All everyone who's been there for me for the beginning and for the band, I can't thank you enough with all my heart. And just coming down the stairs, and then I know you know, and that's why you did it, but my favorite movie of all times is The Wizard of Oz, and that was Tommy's idea to put it in black and white and go to color like The Wizard of Oz. And it was what's really cool, and it sounds so funny, but I believe in this stuff. But when we were in Newsday for March 9th and Sunday's Newsday, I'm the page right after the movie, The Oz. So it's meant to be. I believe that. I really do.
Rub that rock, baby.
But,
rub that rock.
We have just so many exciting things coming up, and I can't thank you for working on our first music video. And I'm so thrilled because it's going to be coming out this month, which is my birthday month. Woohoo! I'm going to be 16.
Cool.
And
you need a chaperone. Yeah.
But no, we're just really excited, and I can't thank you enough for all of your love and support.
I am just so glad that the world can actually see you guys, because I you know. We all know great bands on Long Island. There's a lot of talent on Long Island. And it's really a shame that you know, the world doesn't get to see these people. And I think YouTube has actually helped a lot. I mean, I've sat, you know, when I can't sleep at night, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock in the morning, I wake up, and I'll just go down and sit at the computer, and I'll put on I'll get some guy from, I don't know, whatever, Ethiopia, in a tent playing a guitar, and like,
amazing.
You know, where you never would have gotten to see this guy, you know?
Yeah,
and now
true.
The world is getting to see you guys and see Thank you so much. How talented you really are. And, you know, I think a European tour might be good for you guys over there. I know
you're
all watching all my
Your blood's
my
rock.
Mickey,
they look rock.
He says to tell you you're a superstar.
I'm sorry?
Mickey B.
Mickey B. Mickey B. Mickey
Hi,
B. Mickey, hey.
Thank you.
He said to tell you that you're a superstar.
Aww.
She is a superstar,
Mickey.
And that's why you have good taste. They all are superstars.
I would just like to also thank the wonderful band that opened up for us that night, Angry Dolphin.
Yes, yes.
They were just so awesome.
It was good.
They really were amazing. And, of course, thank you, Richie Cannata, for everything, all of his support, for having the CD recorded at his studio,
right,
for playing on two of the songs and being with us there
day. He was very excited.
It's just been amazing, the amount of love and support from everybody. And
Richie Cannata, we also have on tape, which we all just saw. He promised he's coming in.
Oh, he'll come in.
Richie,
he'll come in.
We want you.
He'll be here.
I don't care whatever you want to do, your ball game, but we want you to do it right there and over here. And also, I had a message from a very special person to tell you today, too, Mr. Neville Chesters, which actually was very ill today. I talked to him because I wanted him to come in and meet you and all you guys, and which was the road manager for Jimi Hendrix, Cream, and The Who.
Yes.
And he worked with Beatles and Zeppelin and everybody. And he, you know, he has seen this. And he called and just wanted me to tell you guys that you guys are incredible. And, I mean, now, there's a guy that worked with three of the biggest bands in the entire world for all times.
Yeah.
So that's quite a compliment.
It's huge.
And,
thank him so
much. I'm a little upset because I didn't go to my voicemails on my way here. We were here all day working, and then when I came back, when I was driving here, Neville, I apologize. I didn't listen to my voicemails. He called back and said I would like to come, but I couldn't have gotten to Malvern.
Okay.
And then back here.
Well, I look forward to meeting him.
Well, he's gonna. He's got to go back to England, but we'll get him. But he loves you guys. He really does.
Thank you.
And he's quite the judge of talent. Let me tell you.
That's huge.
Is he on the phone? Neville is on the phone right now. Neville.
I look forward to meeting you, and thank you so much. What an honor coming from you. Really, truly an honor. Thank you.
Yeah, I think we have a picture over there with Jimi Hendrix. So maybe Tech Tommy, can you bring that picture in? It's in that laying right on the wall over there.
I really can't wait to meet you.
Yeah.
really.
He's a great guy.
It's an honor. It's an honor.
We spent the day with The Who with him.
I know. It's amazing.
I mean, I'm sitting in Pete Townsend's dressing room for like an hour and a half. We had dinner with them and everything.
That was awesome.
Thanks,
awesome.
Neville.
Yeah.
There was three cars parked underneath. There was only three cars allowed underneath in the Coliseum.
Mm-hmm.
Roger Daltrey's, Pete Townsend's, and
mine.
Because it wasn't me. It was because of Neville. They didn't want him to walk
but
or anything,
awesome.
You know, so they hooked him up pretty good.
That was awesome.
And they did a runner, so like while the people were still waiting for the encore, we were on the Meadowbrook Parkway following these guys, following Roger Daltrey and Pete Townsend.
Oh,
so it was really pretty cool.
That's awesome. That's awesome.
I feel that's where you guys are going to be heading soon, and it's just been a great journey to watch. I mean, it's like
you've been there from the beginning since February.
I feel like the guy in the balloon at the end.
Hey, wait.
But it was good. You have to get you had those shoes that you could that night. You
yes,
wore
those I did.
Shoes.
I didn't wear my shoes tonight. You know, I was gonna put them on, and I said, I'll save it for when we come and perform here.
Well, we
I'll
have a picture.
Shoes.
We have.
Oh, you have the picture of the shoes.
Janine took
I saw it. Yes.
Yeah. So,
my glittery shoes.
Do we have to take a break?
Well, we good.
No?
We're good?
Good.
Okay, good. So then I'm excited, since everyone's watching this now, if you don't mind, Wednesday night. I'm very excited. Lord and Taylor from Garden City.
Hold on. What is she? Three? Vicky? Amber? Three?
Talk to them. Okay. So this Wednesday night, April 3rd, I'm very excited and honored to be a part of Lord & Taylor in Garden City. Has a huge event that supports numerous charities. They have so many different personal appearances going on, and I'm one of them, so thank you so much, Lord & Taylor. There will be 100 copies of Electric Blue there. I will be autographing them to everyone personally who gets one. Complimentary compliments of Lord & Taylor.
Oh, nice.
And it's $5 to get in to do shopping and all these extra little goodies, because the $5 goes to a numerous amount of charities. They raise money for so many great, like I said, charities. And I'm also excited because my camera crew is going to be there filming the line of me doing the autographs for the music video. So everyone, you have an opportunity to be in the music video one more time, because she was there shooting March 9th at 89 North Music Venue. Thank you so much, 89 North, for having me have my show there. It's a great venue. Check them out. And it's another opportunity to be in the music video. Come out to Lord & Taylor. I'm going to be there from 5:30 to 6:30. John Stark from the Knicks will be there at 6 p.m. to 6:30, so we'll be there together. He'll be autographing as well. It's going to be a great thing. You can get a copy of the CD for nothing. Compliments of Lord & Taylor, and you can shop in Lord & Taylor. So 25% off, ladies, come on. Just saying.
You can buy your own magical shoes.
Yes. So, yeah, come on out Wednesday night. And then after that, we're getting ready for the next big, tribute show, Joplin's Pearl featuring me. But Tommy Maher, is going to be my special guest, one of my special guests, singing with me as Janice.
We're
it's going to be great.
Tranquilizers that night.
No.
It's very fun.
And we can't tell him the song you're singing, no, so don't announce it. It's a secret. It's a surprise. Also, that night we'll have another guest. My good friend David Salif will be playing with us on a song guitar in the first set. So we have a lot of great things. And my dear friend Ike Avelli, comedian MC. Ike, I love you. He'll be opening the show for us. And we're all excited to rock it. We have a new keyboard player joining us for that show.
Oh, good.
Yes, Linda. How do you say her last name? Anybody know?
Cusimano,
there we go. Thank you, guys. See, I'm horrible. Linda Cusimano. So we welcome her to the tribute show. She'll be on keyboards and singing some backup. So it's going to be a lot of fun. We're all excited.
Very good.
I'm most excited to have you sing next to me.
Well,
you're going to have to bring your rock that night and put next to my rock. I mean, of course, you can put my rock to shame, but that's okay.
Well, you should see the one I got on my stoop.
You could both
I have one this big. Honest to God, this big by this big on my front stoop. On my porch.
That's awesome.
Because I want it coming in from everywhere you can get it.
Well, I'm going to touch the rock because we're going to bring the Joplin show. You know where to? Put your hand here. Bethel.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
That's easy. Gerald, if you're watching, we got to get them up
that
there.
That show would do phenomenal there on those grounds. On the Woodstock grounds. Have you been to Bethel Theater?
Awesome.
That would be great. That would be awesome. Phenomenal. Yeah, I know. Now I feel the heat. Woohoo, the heat is on.
Well, I got to tell you, how much time do we got left? We have 2 minutes left. So I would actually like to donate the 2 minutes to you guys. Whatever you want to tell your fans, which I agree with you, your friends, your followers, your supporters, it's your show. So.
I would just like to thank you for actually what you're doing, bringing out music and talent, because there's a lot of talent on the island, like you said, that people haven't heard of and don't know that's out there. And I think it's a great thing that you're actually exposing that talent. And we had mentioned a few names before.
I thank you, Chris.
But there's a lot of people out there that you're bringing out, and I think that's I would like to compliment you.
I know we want to get Jeff Regan in here and a few others, and. We're gonna get the big guns in here too. We're gonna probably have Vanilla Fudge maybe in here, and I know Vince Martella is definitely gonna come in. Richie Cannata's coming in. I'd like to get Randy Pratt. Rickety's gonna come in. Maybe I'm gonna try to get Cactus in here. Hopefully, keep our fingers crossed. But this is gonna be the place, man. I'm telling you, this is gonna be the place. What do you got to say there, big man?
Thank you. Thank your crew. Thank the fans. Thank everybody. Thank you.
Keep it rocking.
What he said. Definitely what he said.
I have to thank my right-hand woman, Tony Romano.
Yes.
I have to. I love you. She's my...
thing about the outfits, because Was she helped out with the album?
She's my hair lady. Yeah. Her and Rich from New York New Wave was my other sponsor
Tony's
this year.
Great.
She's my everything. She does literally everything for me. She's just
I love her.
She knows this since I'm nine. Yes, she is. And thank you so much. And I want to give a shout out to one of my newest friends slash fans on Facebook who's watching, who's Jane Schilling. Love you. She wanted some happy. Let's give her some happy vibes, everybody. Woohoo, Jane! We can't wait to come to the live show.
I know there's somebody you're missing that I, well, two people you're missing that you really need to. Because I saw the proudness.
Oh,
and the love.
My mom and dad, I never forget
Your
them.
Your dad is such
my
a
My mom
cool
and
dude.
Dad, I don't want to end the show crying, but they have been through everything with me, and they're there supporting me all the way, and they are not stage parents. Let me tell you, everything that I do is not perfect, and they tell me, and that's why I'm able to get better and grow, and I love you, Mom and Dad, for that, and thank you so much for being truthful.
Dad. You know I love talking to you because I talk to him many times, and he's a very, very cool dude.
They're the best.
He is super. And I want to just say what a privilege and honor once again, that you guys were my first guests in this beautiful
and it's an
new
honor.
Studio. And we're going to have you back, and you're going to be playing live on that stage. I can't wait for that. That's going to be outrageous with the lights and the smoke and everything. It's going to be.
And I'm interrupting you. Thank you, everybody, for Madhouse TV for all your love and support. You guys are the best.
Tommy,
I love you. Thank you so much. And I wish you all the best. We wish you all the best in all your endeavors.
And we all wish you peace, happiness, and be safe out there. We'll see you next week right here on the Maverick Soul Hour. I'd like to thank you guys.
Thank you for having us.
It's a privilege and honor. And Owen. It's going to be Vicky's birthday on Thursday.
Woo! Happy birthday,
Vicky.
Baby with me. Woo-hoo.
We love her. We love these guys. And Janine and Tom back there working hard. We love you guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We love all you guys watching. Peace and love to all of you. Keep the music in your life and keep it going. God bless, and we'll see you next Monday. Oh, and I do want to thank New Dawn and Anthony Abate. Thank you so much for last week. You guys were awesome. Big, big audience. Big. I'm saying goodbye now. We're going to hit the dusty trail. Maverick Soul. We'll see you next week. God bless.